Cairo. Alexander, what more can you tell us?
The family, in fact, did not confirm yet the death of Mubarak. It's probably because they don't know which kind of funerals he will have. Will it be official or will it be a funerals for the family only? On the other hand, Mubarak was the only president that left power under the pressure of the street. After 30 years of power, he came to power also in a dramatic way, since he came to power after the assassination of Anwar Sadat in 1981. He was close to him. He took power, he fought against the Islamic movement, and then he kept power. He was the best ally of the Americans until 2003, where he diverged on the invasion of Iraq. He also had good relationship with Israel, and he managed to restore the Egypt back into the Arab world, since Egypt was kicked out of the Arab League.
Alexandra, I was mentioning earlier about how to many Mubarak was seen as a hero, but to many young people, particularly during the Arab Spring, he was seen as a pharaoh, almost a dictator. What will his legacy be? How will he be remembered?
Well, the problem of Mubarak is that he stayed in power 30 years. It never happened since 1952, the first president, Mohammad Naguib, and then Nasser al-Sadat, and so on. And he was, at the end, especially in 2010, perceived by the younger generation as not only a tyrant, but responsible of the fact that Egypt was not evolving anymore, was not progressing, and it was in a sort of paralysis. So when on the 25th of January, the young went to the street, and especially in Tahrir Square in Cairo, Mubarak was in fact unable to control the situation. And not only the streets dictated that he had to leave power, but also the military felt that, in fact, he was becoming a danger, especially that before that, Mubarak wanted his son to succeed to him, and this was not accepted by many, not only the young people, but even by people in the army.
Alexandra, thank you for that. Alexandra Buccianti, they're reporting for us from Cairo. Well, to talk a bit more about this,